Let's go into track number three, which is Drive Me Wild. And let's go to Toe Jam to lead us off into this one.
This is an interesting kind of track. There's no bass or guitar. The drum machine has this flange effect on it. It's very pulsating. It's kind of a soundscape. The album version is kind of the soundscape. It sort of reminds me a bit of Possessed in the background of Purple Rain. It's got a sort of a bit of a computer blue feel about it. It's that Mixolydian sort of synth that he likes doing. The video version is actually a bit more, it's quite longer, and it's got a bit more bass and guitar. I kind of wish, I'm not sure if that was ever actually released anywhere, the video version with those extra instruments, because it's kind of interesting on this one. It's almost a pre Dove's Cry in the fact that it doesn't have much bass or guitar. It's more
is the soundscape video version of drums the same and as vocals. The
single release?
The extended version, yeah.
Not sure, but I remember seeing the video years later and going, "Oh wow, that song's like it's a lot more filled out now. It's more of a song." And
well, he worked on it. To your point, Toe Jam, he worked on it after this song. I mean, normally he releases music and, you know, doesn't work on it. Generally speaking, he moves on to something else. But many months after the single came out. Of Drive Me Wild, which was only like, 2.5 minutes long or something. He did release a 7 or 8 minute version on a 12 inch.
So well, I don't know. Yeah, okay. So I want to know if that, I'm assuming that's the same as the video version.
Yeah, it must be the same. Yeah. It's just over 7 minutes.
Yeah, it must be.
Yeah, but it's kind of interesting on this album though, because it's short and it's more like a little poem and soundscape kind of thing. Interesting. That's all I've got to say for that. It's good for what it is.
For those of you at home, you may want to make your own slightly edited album version, seek out the 7 minute 12 inch single and put it in place of the release single, and that'll make the album about 5 minutes longer and funkier. There you go.
It's a pretty short album. It is a pretty short album.
Yeah, you need the full 7 minutes. player, what are your thoughts of Drive Me Wild?
Yeah, I'm the same. It's a very robotic song, very mechanical, aside from those bell chord chimes sprinkled through it. It doesn't really deviate from that groove, which kind of makes it sound repetitive. It probably was really cutting edge at the time, you know, pre-techno and all that. So it's another thing that kind of Prince was delving into, maybe, you know, testing the waters through these side projects. But yeah, that version that Toe Jam was talking about, where, you know, they've got that underlying Oberheim synth bass and that extended version that has some great guitar by Prince on it towards the end. It's kind of like gives it a bit more of the flavor instead of that mechanical beat that kind of drives the song. But yeah, it's a cool little track, but only 2:30, so it's very short and sweet.
Yeah, it's not long enough to pique too much interest, I'd say. Although on this show, we have said in previous episodes that sometimes Prince has this uncanny ability of putting a lot of ideas and a lot of musical adventure into a small, shorter length song. But this time, to me, it's almost filler. I mentioned the Dolly Parton 9 to 5 comparison. Again, the same comparison.
Great song, that. Great song.
Well, better than this, that's for sure. This, to me, sounds like, again, similar to that sort of TV series theme, at least musically. And in saying that, and as much as I'll say this is just another album track and almost filler, I think, musically, to me, this sounds like the precursor to Automatic, just with the tempo. When you look at the BPM and just the propulsion of this, it sounds like the early beginnings of what would end up being Automatic from an instrument.
I think that's what I meant when I said the computer blue thing. It's got that mechanical, robotic thing about it, hypnotic.
Mm. Yeah. So, yeah, that's basically it. Oh, the last comment I do have here, just in my notes, is it sounds like a mix of Devo and Soft Cell. Soft Cell did Tainted Love, didn't they? I think so.
Yep.
So, Devo and Soft Cell are my two comparisons to this, and I think he was really going for that sound. That was the kind of music that was around during those years.
New wave.
We don't like. Okay, Captain, go ahead.
This song is called Drive Me Wild. Just about I think everyone's compared it to another song, so I'm going to say this reminds me something off 1999 album, and the closest thing I'm thinking is Let's Pretend We're Married.
Yeah, it's more like just it, yeah.
The beat and not so much, that song.
The same synth bass sort of thing.
Yeah. Because you got all this digital bass. Drums and it's got a really dry vocal sound. And the album version, it's really short and I didn't have that much to say about it. But the 12-inch, that's a different thing. It's just over 7 minutes long, and this is a good song. It's got this really funky guitar and all these little synth notes in there. Really long intro. It's I think it's almost 2.5 minutes before the vocals even start. There's really cool guitar solo. Starts at 4:30, and that takes some very interesting turns over the next 2 minutes. And then the whole song ends on just this one long guitar note, and it just keeps going. And yeah, so you go find the extended version if you can. It's a lot better.
And again, this is what, 2.5 minutes long. The extended version is just over 4 minutes.
7:09.
Oh, is it? Oh, wow.
Big difference.
There you go.
Triple the length almost.
You need the full 7 minutes, as we said.